Hi, this is Johnny with Balloon Animals Palm Beach, and today I'm going to show you how to make a balloon that reminds people of a famous mouse. You're going to need two black 260s, one yellow 260, one white 260, one red 260, one blush 260, and also you're going to need a little black 260 scrap that you're going to use to make one finger bubble with about a 2 or 3 finger tail for the nose. So you're going to go ahead and grab your red 260 and inflate it until it has about an 8 finger tail. Four, 8 finger tail. Now you're going to make a small little 4 finger loop, twist that together, pull the nozzle through to lock that in place. And now we're going to do 5 of those all together, so 4 more of the 4 finger loops. Now you're going to get rid of the extra. Tie it off. Loop it around to keep it in place. Hide it. Adjust your loop so it's like a flower. This is going to be his shorts. Now we're going to go ahead and grab the black 260 and inflate it so it has about an 8 or 10 finger tail. Now you want to make a 4 finger bubble. Make a second 4 finger bubble for his body. Make a third 4 finger bubble. And twist those two together. Now you're going to make a fourth 4 finger bubble. And you want to roll this bubble through these two bubbles, like so. So now you've got an arm and his body, and then this is going to be his legs. And now we want to attach this black 260 to the red 260 by just pulling it between the two loops. And you adjust it so that this balloon comes out one side and these bubbles come out this side. Now you're going to go ahead and grab your yellow 260 and inflate it so it has about a 10 or 12 finger tail. Four, 8, 10 finger tail. Now you're going to go ahead and make a little 1 finger bubble. Now you're going to make a little 2 finger bubble. Make a second 2 finger bubble. Twist those two together. Now you're going to make this balloon soft and you're going to draw it over the top of the 2 finger bubbles. And then twist that into place. And that's one of his shoes. Now we're going to go ahead and grab this black balloon. We're going to go down 6 fingers. Make a 6 finger bubble, and now you're going to just twist the little 1 finger bubble into the black balloon. And now you're going to take both the black and yellow balloon and make a little 1 or 2 finger spacer bubble. And now you're going to take your yellow balloon and make a little 2 finger bubble. Make a second 2 finger bubble. Twist those two together. And now you want to make this balloon nice and soft, and you're going to draw it over the 2 finger bubbles you just made. And twist that off for his other shoe. Now you just make one little 1 finger bubble with the yellow balloon. Get rid of the extra. Tie that off. and that's his two shoes. So now we want to bring this black balloon back up, make his other leg part of his body and his other arm. So you're going to do a six finger bubble, same size as this other leg. And then you want to just twist that in to the red balloon and around the black balloon. You just want to make a little four finger bubble with the black balloon the same size as these and twist that together at the top. Okay. Then you want to make a four finger bubble the same size as this one for his other arm. And then you can get rid of the extra. And tie that off. So this is his body so far. Now you're going to go ahead and do his head. So you want to grab your blush 260 and you're going to inflate it until it has about a 10 finger tail. Four, eight, or nine finger tails, okay too. And now you're gonna grab that black 260 scrap that you made a one finger bubble in and left a little three or four finger tail on, and you're gonna tie the black scrap to the blush 260. Like so. This is gonna be his nose. So now we're gonna create a tulip twist by putting our index finger on the knot we just tied and pushing that into the blush bubble about three fingers deep. You're gonna grab the knot with this hand and you're gonna use these fingers to push the balloon away from your index finger as you pull your index finger out while holding on to the knot of the black 260. Then you're just gonna adjust. And now you're going to twist the blush balloon in front of the knot that you're holding so that you end up with a nice two-finger bubble in the blush balloon. This is gonna be his nose and snout. Now you wanna make a pinch twist in the blush balloon, about a medium size. You don't wanna be too small, you don't wanna be too big. And that's gonna be his mouth. Now you're gonna go ahead and grab your other black 260 and inflate that until it has about a 10 finger tail. Four, eight, 10, well this is an 11 finger tail and that's okay too. So we're gonna take this nozzle and we're going to just twist it into the pinch twist here in the blush balloon. Now you're gonna make a little three finger bubble with your black balloon, and you're gonna make a little three finger bubble with your blush balloon. You want them to be the same size. And then, and of course mine aren't the same size. Okay, and then you're gonna twist those together. Now you wanna make another little three finger bubble with your black balloon, the same size as this bubble. You can just twist that in place. And now you want to make a little three finger bubble with your blush balloon, the same size as this bubble. And you can twist that around the snout. And you can twist all four of these bubbles once around to hold everything in place. Now you want to have the blush balloon coming out the side. This is his snout and his nose, so that's the front. These are his eyes. This is the back of his head. So you have the black balloon coming out the back, and you have the blush balloon coming out the side, and you want to make a little two-finger bubble with the blush balloon and make another little two-finger bubble the same size, and then twist those two together. And now you're just going to draw your blush balloon under the pinch twist to the other side of the head, and now you're going to make another little two-finger bubble and another little two-finger bubble and twist those together. That's going to be his cheeks. And then you can just draw this blush balloon around the black balloon once and back down. Now you're going to take this black balloon and you're going to draw it under his cheeks here, and you want to squish all the air out of it, completely deflate it, and draw it up in between the two-finger bubbles that make his cheek. And now you're going to make a little two-finger bubble in the black balloon, and another little two-finger bubble, a third two-finger bubble, and you want to twist those last two-finger bubbles together. Now you want to make this balloon nice and soft. You're going to draw it over the top of the two-finger bubbles you just twisted together, and this makes his ear. Now you're going to make another little small two or three finger bubble, and another little small two finger bubble, another little small two finger bubble, and twist those last two finger bubbles together. Now you want to make this balloon nice and soft and draw it over the top of these two finger bubbles and twist that all together to make his other ear. Now you're going to go ahead and make one more little two-finger bubble, and you want it to be the exact same size or as close as possible to the two-finger bubble you started with on the other side of his face. And then you're going to get rid of the extra, but you want to leave some tail because you're going to use that to tie it all in. Tie that off. And now you're going to make sure this balloon's still deflated, pulled up between his two cheek bubbles, and you want to pull all of this over the top of his head and pull this tail to the other side of his head, and now you're going to tuck it into these two cheek bubbles on the other side. So you just pull them up, push this tail through the two cheek bubbles, and make sure that you've got this bubble stretched down all the way. Because however this ties is how his head's going to look. All right, and once you've got it where you want it, you just wrap it through a couple more times to lock it in place. So that's his head. I'm going to just get rid of this extra here. And obviously my bubble turned out a little too soft, so it's longer than this one, which is what makes the head crooked. All right. Anyway, we're going to go ahead and take the blush balloon and we're going to make a pinch twist in the back here. And now I like to go ahead and do one more little one-finger bubble for his neck. I do a really small one. And then I do two more little pinch twists to hold his neck in place. I have to let out a little bit of air here. And now I can get rid of the extra. Tie this off. wrap this around. And I'm saving some tail so that I can attach the head to the body. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and grab the body and take the tail of the head, and I'm just gonna twist it into the top of the body here in between the arms. Pull it through these bubbles here. And wrap the tail around the pinch twist to hold everything in place. Now I'm just gonna tuck his arm down in between the bubbles in his body, the body bubbles. Like so, and adjust his two pinch twists on his neck so that his head is straight. Turn his head the right direction. And I'm gonna add on his hands last. So now his hands are the white 260 balloon. Grab your white 260 balloon and inflate it just a little bit. So just about 18 or 19 fingers worth of inflated balloon. And we're gonna make a little tiny one finger bubble and a little tiny pinch twist. Second little tiny pinch twist, and then a little tiny two finger bubble, and a second little tiny two finger bubble, and go ahead and twist those together. And my little first one finger bubble popped, so I'm gonna add that in. And now I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of the extra, but I'm gonna save this to make his other hand. Tie this off. And now I can go ahead and attach this hand onto the end of his arm. Just wrap this black balloon into the white balloon. So there's his little hand, and I would normally cut this extra off. I'm gonna grab the scrap of my white 260 and make his other hand. Just inflate it a little bit. A little one finger bubble. A little pinch twist. A second little pinch twist. And a little two finger bubble. Another little two finger bubble. Twist those two together. Get rid of the extra. Tie that off. Wrap it around. Tie it. Okay, and then I'm just gonna go ahead and attach this to his other arm by wrapping the black balloon around it. And that's the Mickey. Now, there's a couple finishing touches you can do. I draw some eyes here. I put a little red mouth, some yellow buttons, and a tail. I use a red balloon that's just about 3-4, no more than 5 fingers long. I put a little bit of air in it so it's inflated, it's not flat. And then I just tuck each corner up into his little cheek bubbles under the snout above the pinch twist. Thank you. So he's got a little red mouth. And then I take the two yellow scraps, I make a little one finger bubble and leave, you know, about a 3 or 4 finger tail. I take these two yellow scraps and tie them together. Get rid of the extra. And then I just push them through one of the red loops. And then that gives him two little yellow buttons. Whoops, he's turned around. And then the last thing is I take a tail, which is just a black scrap, the little two finger bubble, and a little 4 or 5 finger tip, and just twist that into the back for his tail. Now he's got a little tail, then I just draw the eyes on. I use a black Sharpie and a white Sharpie paint pen. So if you like the video, you can just click like, or you can leave me feedback in the comments. And you can subscribe to my channel. I release videos on a regular basis. Or you can check me out on Facebook or go to my website, balloonanimalspalmbeach.com, for more information. Give him a little eyebrow. Grab my white paint pen. So this is what his eyes look like, and his mouth, and his buttons. And of course I arrange him so he's all facing one direction, but that's the Mickey Mouse. Well, the balloon that reminds people of Mickey Mouse, not an actual Mickey Mouse.